Can sleeping extra on weekends make up for your sleep loss that you occurred during the week? And what is really the impact of not getting enough sleep on your overall health? And are there any tips and strategies that you can do to improve the quality of your sleep? Let's take a look at all of these and more in today's video. And as always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I would love to hear your thoughts and comments below. As you know, the American Academy of Sleep Medicine recommends getting more than 7 hours of sleep a night. Now, sleep is actually a risk factor for both diabetes and obesity. And when it comes to obesity, cardiovascular disease and diabetes were number one and number two leading causes of death from obesity. Sleep is interesting that if you don't get enough, it leads to all sorts of negative changes across your body. And we call those metabolic dysregulation. Essentially, people become hungrier. You see that their circadian rhythms get delayed and even insulin sensitivity goes down. Not to mention other things like there's higher risk of falls, there's higher risk of cognitive or memory decline, and even risk for dementia. In this study, what the authors wanted to look at was, really, let's answer this question about letting people sleep extra on weekend. Will it help to undo the negative effects of not sleeping enough during the week? So what they did was they had three separate arms. The first arm was the control arm where people got to sleep as much as they wanted. The second arm was where they basically restricted their sleep to 5 hours. And the third arm was the weekend recovery. So in other words, they restricted their sleep to 5 hours during the week. Then they allowed them to catch up on their sleep on Saturday and Sunday. There were 36 people in this trial. Average age was about 25. BMI was normal. And they had about 14 people in both of the sleep restriction groups. So what did they find? When they looked at slow wave sleep, which is basically the deepest phase of our non-REM sleep, it's commonly associated with things like how good your sleep quality is. What they showed there was that people who were sleep deprived, they got less slow wave sleep. Now that's expected. And then when they were allowed to have weekend recovery, their slow wave sleep actually went back up as expected. So far so good. Slow wave sleep, weekend recovery, it comes back. Then they looked at melatonin onset, and what they were looking here was, how does melatonin secretion occur? Remember, melatonin, basically when there's darkness, our pineal gland in the brain, it basically secretes melatonin, and melatonin helps us to fall asleep. So in this particular one, they took blood samples. They wanted to see, when is that melatonin secretion occurring? As they caused people to have sleep restriction, their melatonin secretion actually went further and further. And when they allowed them to have weekend recovery 2 days and then they went back to sleep restriction, it didn't fix the delayed onset of melatonin release. In other words, it actually makes it harder for them to fall asleep simply by not sleeping for a couple of nights. This is why it is so important to have regular sleep patterns and go to bed at the same time every night. Those folks who were not getting enough sleep, both the ones that were sleep restricted and the ones that were allowed to have weekend recovery, they both had a lot of hunger, especially after dinner. And the kinds of foods they were consuming really weren't the healthy types. They were the ones that were high in sugar, high in simple carbohydrates. And this occurred regardless of whether they were allowed to have weekend recovery. If you let these guys sleep extra on the weekend, but then go back to sleep restriction, they had those same hunger cravings come right back, and even more than before. Even when they looked at insulin sensitivity, what they saw was that whole body insulin sensitivity, looking at day 12, dropped 13% with sleep restriction. And even if you allowed them to have weekend recovery and then continued with sleep restriction, they had a 27% drop in insulin sensitivity. So really, what is the bottom line here? Well, there's three key points. First, you gotta sleep 7 to 9 hours. Sleeping more than 7 hours is critical to optimal health. And in order to do that, you wanna set up a good sleep hygiene. Have some kind of a regimen that you do. Take a warm shower, go ahead and relax in bed, read a book, make sure there's no bright lights in the room, alarm clocks, all those things should be off so that you're not seeing any kind of lights disrupting your melatonin secretion. Make sure that you're not trying to play this catch-up game, because catch-up sleep on weekends does not work. In fact, it could even make the problem worse if you're going back and forth, back and forth. And lastly, realize that poor sleep doesn't just make you feel tired. It also increases hunger, increases mostly in people things like delayed melatonin onset, insulin resistance, and can even be associated with things like later on in life, onsets of dementia or decline in memory. Thanks so much for watching. As always, please, Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I would love to see your comments below. And please, if you have any ideas on next topics, let me know. I'll see you next time.